guys. My name is Oleg, and in this video we're talking about transmission adaptation, clutches, pressure, engagements, point of the engagements, and all this crap. This is for DL501, and I think it's DQ500, it's pretty much same thing. Maybe different parameters of the adaptation. My car is Audi 2013 Audi S5 DSG. Is, you know, S-Tronic 501 DL501, second generation. It's not stuck, it's already modified. I had DCT stage 3 clutch pack kit, which is rated 1200 Nm, even more because this was made special by car. They increased a little bit more clamp force. I think it should be like 1300 or some or so. Alright, whatever. Let's start it from adaptation. So pretty much that's your webcam, right? You need a full version of the webcam. This is at this current time, last test version 19.6. So we press select. We got auto transmission. Let me go back. So it's O2, auto trans. Press this one. Before I do anything, just read for the code, no code, which is good. If you have any code, you have to, you know, see what's going on and clear it. Because if you have any code in the transmission, it will not do any adaptation, as far as I know. It could do it, but not 100%. Alright. So, you go basic settings. Right away, you press show measuring data. Usually I like to put let's say pressure for the search bar. So we need clutch pressure. Clutch pressure data, which is showing pretty much the same parameters, and what's the difference? And nominal pressure of the clutch 1, nominal pressure of the clutch 2, nominal pressure shaft 1, nominal pressure shaft 2. Then we go to clutch. So you choose clutch temp. Specific torque, you don't need it. And then, this is most important, clutch adaptation. Lower, upper one, and lower, upper two clutch. All right, this is definitely needed. Oh. Okay, let's remove, it's not enough, so let's remove this pressure clutch data. This one, we don't need it. We have it once already, so fuck it. And I would like to have transmission fluid temperature. So just put it temp. So transmission fluid temperature. That's it. That's all you gotta see what changes will be made while it's do the adaptation on the transmission. And see the value of the difference. I just did it recently yesterday because I have issue in the shifts. And I have sometimes issue with the clutch. It's a little bit was too aggressive, and it's like dumping clutch is too aggressive, which is not comfortable, and I have pretty bad quarter mile times because of that slip clutch. As soon as I did this, it's all the problems goes away. Car runs so much smoother. So here's your parameters at this time. Transmission fluid temperature. Make sure your car is up to temperature, at least 70 Celsius. So this is current adaptation point, 2 bar, 2.5 bar, upper lower clutch, 6 bar, 2.5 and 6.5, so it's pretty equal, right? No pressure in the clutch because it's in the neutral, nominal pressure 2.5 bars, and the shaft is 3 bar, and temp of the clutch is 93. So this will change when you do the adaptation as well. So let's start from the adaptation. That's where you're going to Usually you pretty much you can go from just all of them, just from the top to the bottom. All the adaptation you see, it says adaptation. Let's say main pressure valve calibration, clutch valve calibration, distance sensor calibration, clutch engagement point adaptation. Actually, you know what? Do the erase counter to start the progress. You can do that. You can. You have to erase this start point adaptation, the factory settings first, and that's it. Oh, and gear reset the gear sealing measurement the counter as well. So it's gonna start over again. So, and then you start from the top. Clutch valve calibration, distance sensor calibration, clutch engagement, drag torque test, cooling valve wear measurements, and that's it. You gotta go through the each steps. Let's do this just for example. Main valve or this is the sensor calibration, right? Just press go. It says running. I can hear how it clicks. Transmission. You can see also changing the pressure and the pressure shaft. Totally normal, don't be afraid. So you see it says finish it correctly, so all of them should say finish it correctly. Some of them takes a little bit time, and so you have to wait. If it's freeze for some reason, close it and do over again. So you press go back. Oh, sorry, I closed by the accident. I'm sorry. So yeah, go over all of them and you should see the difference. I recommend do that if your car, let's say stage 2 plus dual pulley E85, and you make 4 plus the wheels, you must do that every 4 months, because every 4 months on my car is a big difference. It's losing a little bit pressure, different I guess pressure calibrations over the time because of the temperature, of the weather outside, and all this crap, maybe because of the heavy performance clutches as well. So yeah, anyway, it's good to do, just, you know, when you do oil change, let's say I would do that as well. So like I said, in my car it helps a lot. I put down already about 3 or 4 thousand, probably close to 4,000 on DCT clutch, as you know, Dima Deca, and I'm really happy. Car drives like really stock. It was from the beginning only a little bit aggressive shifting, but when I did, like, this is actually I did fifth time adaptation yesterday from the summertime, and every time car just drive more smooth, more stronger, and much better. So please do that. Make sure you take care of your car. Do all this every 4 months or every oil change. Peace.